In this video today, we are so excited to give you a tour of the all-new GetResponse. The new GetResponse is your command center for your online marketing activities. It's an all-in-one, user-friendly, fully integrated platform. And so what's new with GetResponse? Well, everything. Your GetResponse account now is made up of several integrated modules that all work together, so everything is synced. This is streamlining all of your activities, like your email marketing work, like email creation, adding and managing your contacts, managing and creating automation workflows, webinars, and landing pages all together. And so why have we done this? Why the update to the all-new GetResponse? Well, it's because we listen, and this is all based on your feedback to make everything much more intuitive and easier to navigate as well. And so in the video today, we're going to go through all of the new account architecture that you'll find, a fully customizable interface that we can look at, the widget-based dashboard, and of course, as well, just the complete new design and layout, and we'll make sure you know where to find everything that you need. And of course, I'm also excited to announce and briefly talk about our brand new functionality, a customer relationship management tool, aka a CRM tool right here within your GetResponse account. For now, you can switch between the all-new GetResponse and the previous version of your account to make the transition super simple and painless, but we do hope you'll spend a lot of time here in the new GetResponse and get to know and see how easy it is to actually do all of your online marketing work now. So let's go ahead and start the tour. And so we can of course start here in your brand new dashboard. So we'll see right here within the dashboard, all of the new things that we have, and hopefully things are gonna be a lot simpler to navigate and customize as well. So I can start here with the top toolbar. Basically, these are just all the feature spaces that you're gonna be able to easily move around within the account. So you'll see some, you know, familiar faces, hopefully contacts, for example, landing pages and webinars. But you'll also see that forms and surveys have been combined within one feature space. And then, of course, that brand new functionality of CRM here as well. Continuing along the toolbar is the help access, so you can always, of course, call, connect with live chat, all of what you could previously do before. And then your My Account menu is right here in the top right corner as well, and it's always been located right there, so hopefully it's totally natural for you to go there to manage your account, check out your billing, the multimedia studio, all of those things. But what's probably the most new for you is going to be this widget-based dashboard. So these are all widgets that are fully customizable and meant for you to be able to use and customize to make sure that you see the most important statistics, the most important actions and information right at a glance, right whenever you log in or reach your dashboard. And so you can easily add as many widgets as you want. You can simply choose the Add New Widget button, visit the widget library, and read about what some of them offer you, and go ahead and add them to your dashboard. And also, once a widget is on your dashboard, when you hover, you can see there's a little settings icon here. You simply can click that and you'll specify the widget settings. So select the lists that you want to be included or remove a widget. And then you'll simply save it and it will save your settings. So the widgets are a really great way for you to be able to get at a glance immediate information. Also complete some quick actions. Of course, we'll talk about how you can do all of these things within their feature spaces, but it's really cool straight from the dashboard if you're always quickly needing to add contacts or create a newsletter or create a workflow. You can do it straight here from the quick actions, of course, widget as well. So this is gonna be the really customizable part of your dashboard, that you have full control over what it is you need a quick glance at when you get started. And also here on the dashboard, you may see some new terms or maybe something missing. Basically, because campaigns, which you previously knew as campaigns, are now known as contact lists. And so you may see that usually you were used to seeing something called a Your Current Campaign menu in the top right corner of your account. And so that's not going to be there anymore. And basically, lists are now going to be present within contacts. And I'll go through that more whenever we visit the contacts feature space. But that's something perhaps that you would notice that you didn't have in this new version of GetResponse as you did in the previous version of your dashboard. But don't worry, they're now called lists, and you'll find all their information within the contacts section as well. And maybe you got used on the top toolbar, for example, to see messages. You know, you always saw messages right here. Well, of course, messages are a part of our email marketing, our newsletters, our autoresponders, so that will be located within our email marketing space. But we'll take a quick look within each of them and make sure you know where to access everything that you need. And so let's go ahead and click through the feature tiles and see what we can find. And of course, with contacts is where we're going to really probably be able to spend a moment here within the video to make sure you all are comfortable with the new layout and know where to find everything. And so anytime you actually click on one of the feature spaces, you're always brought essentially to the manage page of that particular feature space. And so in this case, whenever you're working within contacts, you're brought to your contact lists, remembering previously that these were your campaigns. So we've simply changed the terminology because, of course, what are contact lists, but lists of your contacts. And so it should be a pretty, simple phrase to get used to when referring to, what were your campaigns, now simply are your lists. You'll also see that anytime you reach within a feature space, like I said, you go to the manage page for that space. Always on the top right corner of the space will be the option to add or create. So in this case, you'll see you can easily add contacts straight right from here from your contact lists, or to create a list right here. And so you'll see this is all done to make it simpler. Previously, within the contact layout of the previous panel, you had to move between different screens, essentially in different spaces of your account, to add contacts or create a campaign. And because these things are all very closely related, now they're actually in one space. You're not having to move all around the account. You'll also see that whenever you come within a feature space, there's the additional options here in a new top toolbar for all the things you can do within that space. So of course, searching for contacts, subscription statistics, because that's contact related, suppression list, custom fields, and import statistics as well. You'll see that previously within email analytics is where you would kind of find within your statistics panel the import statistics. So previously in your account, there was a statistics menu at the top, and that's where you found your import statistics. But of course, what are imports but imports of contacts? And so now it just makes more sense for your import statistics to be available here within contacts. And you'll see that as well for other statistics, like for your emails as well, that they're now located within email marketing instead of having a dedicated statistics panel for all the different things you'll do. They're organized within their own feature space. So it's something else to keep an eye out for. And also within your contact lists here, keep an eye out for these three dots, which is an action menu, which of course just gives you more options for this particular screen. And so within this actions menu, you'll see additional options for the list. Add contacts to it, so you can choose the way you want to add, making a list a default list. And also this is how you will be able to access the settings for this particular list. So we can go ahead and choose that. And the list settings, again, are what were your campaign settings, and they're still made up of the three sections as they previously were. Previously, your campaign settings were made up of a general profile and permission, it was called, different groups. Now you'll just see it named a bit differently, of course, general, which is general information about this particular list. And within subscription is where you'll simply set up the subscription settings for how people can join. For example, your confirmed or double opt-in or single opt-in settings as well. And a confirmation message is, of course, if you have a confirmed opt-in enabled, the confirmation message is what is sent. And so here within this section of list settings, you could specify what type of confirmation message should be sent. And you'll see how easy it is to always get back to where it is you were. For example, with going through contact lists or utilizing this navigation panel here, which is really handy as well. You'll also see how easy it is to add contacts. You can see by expanding your contact database, you can choose the list you want to be able to add the contacts to. And then right here on one space, you're able to choose if you want to add them manually or import your contacts. And again, previously you had to kind of move around the account a bit more to be able to do that. And so you'll see that the process of actually importing contacts and adding them is very simple and familiar to how you were able to do it previously. And quickly, I will just go into the search contacts area because that's going to be another new kind of view for you. So search contacts, of course, brings up all of the contacts that you have in your account quite quickly, you can see. But then you can specify it by specifying the lists, subscription dates, which you were always able to do. And also something new here, you'll see basically what were referred to as your saved searches are now simply called custom filters. And so saved searches is how you create those specific groups of contacts that you created by searching via specific conditions. So you'll see that you can actually do a specified search by choosing the conditions, and then specify condition categories, like are you going to search based on your contact details, maybe their contact actions, things that they actually have done, their location, scoring, and tags. So the same search options you had, but now organized in a more intuitive and, you know, easy to access way, for example, for doing those searches. And so once you conducted some type of specific search, you could, for example, simply then save it as what is now known as a custom filter and be able to send a targeted newsletter to them or whatever else you're wanting to do. But essentially, custom filter are what were called saved searches. And now I could talk about contacts probably forever because, you know, this is a really cool part of the account, but I will continue the tour and show you around the other aspects as well. Next being email marketing. You'll see how easy it is to move around the account, getting back to your dashboard and through the other feature spaces as well. And so, of course, email marketing are the messages you're sending to your contacts. So you'll see, again, you're brought to the manage page for email marketing for newsletters. And on the top right corner is where you can create a new newsletter. And remember, don't forget about that quick actions widget on your dashboard is another quick and easy way to go straight from your dashboard to creating a newsletter. And I should mention that the creation process for your newsletters and your autoresponders, RSS to email, is just the same. It just looks a little bit different than it previously did to get to those spaces, but the process of creating them is exactly as it was before, so don't worry about that. And so remember, this is your newsletters option. There's that actions menu that hopefully you guys will get used to seeing for the additional options that you always had for your newsletters, creating them, and your autoresponders, be able to organize them by your lists. And of course, you could view in the list view or the calendar view. So all of that is going to be just the same with your option to create new as well right here. Your RSS to email, and of course, as I mentioned, now all of the statistics related to your email marketing, to the messages you're sending, are located right here within statistics in the email marketing space. And so we can go now within the different feature spaces, and for example, for automation, landing pages, and webinars, you're simply going to reach the manage page for each of those feature spaces, and in the top right corner, you'll be able to create the additional landing page or automation workflow or webinar. And then each on the manage page has the actions menu for additional options for those, just the same as it was. So I can briefly talk about forms and surveys. Now they are combined because, of course, forms and surveys are quite similar to each other. Forms are used, of course, to sign up to a list and get more information. And surveys, of course, you know, are where you can gather more data about your subscribers. So these are, you know, related features. So they're now combined within one feature space. But again, the option to create a form on the right side here, with your manage forms being the default, and managing your surveys as well, giving you the option to create a new survey right here. So hopefully you just always know to navigate toward the right corner for the additional options that you have for creating or adding something new. And of course, there is the brand new CRM feature as well. And so this is where you're going to be able to use what we call sales pipelines to turn your email leads actually into sales, into repeat customers. And so this is done by, you know, creating and managing custom sales pipelines, you know, a sales process to be able to, you know, move your leads through different stages that you set up and hopefully into, you know, repeat won deals and customers. And so I know you probably want to see a lot more about the CRM feature. So please check out our dedicated resources for that and learn all about the way you can actually get the most out of this, you know, all-in-one CRM feature located right within your GetResponse account. And so the main thing we just want you to know is that you have full, you know, customization options for what you're going to see on your dashboard. And remember, you can easily navigate within the account by the feature tiles, your quick actions menu, and also whenever you're within a feature space, you can move around very easily with this navigation toolbar as well. And whenever you choose a feature space, you go to the manage page and you can always create or add something new from the buttons on the right top side. And so please, we hope you all have such a great time taking your own tour within the all new GetResponse and spend a lot of time in it and you like it as much as we do.